What's important is that you listen to what I have to say, not myself. On my behalf, welcome to you all. I hope you enjoyed the meal and are strong enough to follow the next topic, which is the relationship between mid-elevation mountain ranges and their impact on the climate in Saxony. So these uplands and their impacts on the climate are to be investigated, whether they remain the same or whether there is a change also under this aspect. When speaking about climate in Saxony, we have to see that the uplands are only one impact, one aspect of a set of conditions. That depends, of course, of the direction of air masses, of airflow and meteorological flows, and where we get the data from, under which conditions. When we have a south streams of air masses, then we have it outside the uplands, but in north streams we have the impact in Saxony. But it's kind of a modular kit. We have supra-regional influences for northern streams. We have impact from the lowlands of the northern central Europe, which are more maritime and continental. Then we have the transitional climate of Central Europe. This is the boundary region, transitional region between Atlantic-based climate of Western Europe and the more continental climate of Central Europe, and Saxony belongs to the latter. And then the main wind direction is west wind, which causes less extremes in terms of high temperatures, low temperatures in our region. So we can see that the uplands have a strong impact on the climate in Saxony, but they are not the only factor. When having a closer look to the uplands and their impact, then we can see that that it can be broken down into various components. The main component is the change of climate in terms of altitude, of elevation. So we have altitude gradients showing that temperature becomes lower the higher the mountains are, and we have more precipitation, more wind and more fog. The second differentiation which we find is the change in continentality in Saxony. In West Saxony we have more maritime influences than in East Saxony or in the rest of Saxony, which causes less precipitation at same altitudes, have more sun hours and less winter strength, although it's the same level in altitude. The next differentiation refers to shadowing effects, to upwind, downwind effects depending on the streams, the airflow directions. So the uplands are kind of barrier, and it means that on the upwind side we have more precipitation, more wind, and on the downwind side we have less precipitation at same altitudes, and there are various other phenomena. For example, if the wind comes from southwest, then we can have foehn winds in the central or mountains region with more sun hours, so a longer duration of sunshine, of sun irradiation. And the final component, and which is rather particular for the Saxon region, is the impact of regional wind systems. We have the Bohemian wind, which is a cold airflow, Jahreszeit bei entsprechender Wetterlage, also during less sunshine, which cause pressure differentiation, a so-called inversion weather situation, so that the wind comes from the Bohemian Basin towards Saxony and overcomes the uplands barrier, so that in the east Ore Mountains and in the Zittau Mountains we have lower temperature in terms of mean values in comparison with Central Saxony and East Saxony. This is a highly specific Saxon phenomenon. Let's get closer, deeper into detail. The function, the dependency on the sea level. During the past 21 years, we have here the trend analysis, the trend curve, and we see a clear elevation dependency, altitude dependency, even for the wind-corrected precipitation values. Certain measuring stations show a deviation to the one side and others to the other side, localized differentiations depending on shadowing effects for the annual average temperature in Saxony. We see a strong dependency on the sea level, so the altitude above sea level. So we see deviations which are highly local and due to local phenomena, for example, cold air lakes, as we call it, forming in certain parts of Saxony, and due to the wind from Saxon, from the Bohemian Basin. This dependency on the elevation above sea level can also be seen for other parameters. For example, for the radiation in summer, when atmosphere is properly mixed and we have good clouds, then we have a decrease in radiation because of an increase in cloud formation, the higher we come. So we have a higher frequency in of clouds causing a reduction in global radiation. On the other hand, we have an increase in continentality. That means in East Saxony there are several percent more radiation than in the Western Saxony, so Western Eastern growth. And wind speed, wind velocity, there we have an increase by height, by elevation. The higher we come, the more wind there is. But again, we have variability due to valley mountain correlations. But basically, we can say the higher we come in the mountains, the more wind we are likely to have. For example, in the sandstone mountains, we have less wind, and we can also see the impact of the land use, so less wind speed if we have more forest, as in East Saxony. As already mentioned, another characteristic feature of the uplands impact is the upwind-downwind effect. So depending on the impact flow, so the Western Ore Mountains form a kind of barrier for the Eastern Uplands, so we have variation between the two parts. That means the highest precipitation can be found in the downwind section, in the upwind, and we have less precipitation in the downwind direction in the other parts of the Erzgebirge or mountains. This similar effect can be seen from the radiation in winter. There are the shadowing effects are higher or stronger than in summer. There we see that in the east of the Ore Mountains we have less radiation than in the central and western Ore Mountains. This is due to the flow impact, wind impact. In the east, we have the Bohemian wind causing fogs, getting over the ridge, westlichen Erzgebirge and causing more precipitation. Whereas we have phoen wind effects in the western, on the western side, which with more sun hours, with more sunshine hours and other effects. One characteristic feature of the winter periods are what we call the inversion conditions. I show you that for two zones. We have here two curves, the temperature distribution for a certain day, for a given day, it's early November, 3rd of November at a certain time, 8 o'clock a.m. And there's a we see the comparison between the western and the eastern part of the Ore Mountains. So the inversion means higher temperatures because of warmer air streams in higher levels of the atmosphere, and there we see that we have a stronger impact. For example, for Leipzig it's 0 degrees and 14 degrees above zero for the Fichteberg, the highest mountain of the Ore Mountains. When we compare it with the east Ore Mountains, there we see an inversion also, but only at certain elevations, and beyond that, you see this the same level, it's much colder because of the cold stream, air stream from the Bohemian Basin. You can see that over there. So, and the Bohemian wind has a stronger impact on the eastern part of the Ore Mountains due to the general topography of these mountains, and that is why we have this differentiation between the western part and the eastern part of the Ore Mountains, especially during winter. This is another picture, a map showing 2008, 11th of January, 11 a.m., typical Bohemian wind situation. We have an inversion condition, a pressure difference against a low pressure cyclone from the Atlantic. We have a cold air pool above the Bohemian Basin. The wind flows over the ridge of the Ore Mountains, and then we have a shadowing effect from the other regions of the uplands, which causes temperature changes, colder temperatures, even in the valley of the River Elbe. So in the central Ore Mountains, we have a phoen wind, that means plus 10 degrees Celsius for our, and minus 3 in the east. So these are quite large differences at such short distances. This is a particularity of the uplands climate in Saxony, radiation in summer and winter. Once we have this pressure contrast, low pressure in the west, high pressure from the east, then we find this cold air pool in Bohemia, in the Bohemian Basin. At a certain point of time, the cold wind will cross the ridge of the Ore Mountains and then cause these high differences in temperature between the two parts of the Ore Mountains. And sometimes there's even phoen wind, as this day shown here, the 11th of January 2008. With high contrast in temperature. So these are the flow directions, the approximate flow directions, and the color shows the temperature related to those air streams. Also in the longer run, we see consequences when showing temperature and radiation distribution curves. Temperature, we see difference between the town of Zinnwald and the highest mountain, Fichtelberg, in winter time, on a cumulative basis, if the difference is higher than zero for Zimbalt, it was warmer than Fichteberg. If below zero, it's lower than Fichteberg. Then there's a difference in height of 330 meters. And so you can see this frequency distribution that in 25% of all winter hours evaluated, Zinnwald was colder than the Fichteberg peak, although lying at a lower elevation. Here you see the wind chart for Zinnwald and for Fichteberg. You cannot see the numbers in the room from the back seats, but you can see the general trend. So for Fichteberg, it's what we expect from a kind of isolated peak summit. You see the west wind as the most frequent wind, but for Zinnwald is also a mountainous measuring station. And there you can see it's not west, but it's south, which means the regional Bohemian wind coming from the south. On the east slope of the Ore Mountains. So this is for the current condition, the current state. But how about the future? What is the trend? Regardless of which regional model we take, we have whether the dynamic regional model CLM, or whether we use you see the increase in temperature for daily maxima, and that is also true for the uplands. You see the upper boundary, the 99% of percentiles, means what is beyond these numbers is outside. This is, and you see a rather clear increase from 34 degrees Celsius today's condition to 38 degrees by the end of the century. It is quite a change. The question is now whether there will be whether the future change will be different from what we extrapolate here, and for that reason, let's have a look at the time series of the height gradients. This is the intersection with the ordinal. You have the expected temperature change, anticipated temperature change, and in the bottom we have the height gradient. And so that means that the height gradient is rather constant. So we cannot expect a difference to appear at this point. That means the warming. The warming has a homogeneous general effect on the situation. For precipitation, you see a slight reduction in precipitation, and the height gradient is expected to remain the same. So it's the same statement. That means the change in precipitation will be seen in almost all levels of the uplands. So for all height gradients, it's the same impact anticipated.
Wenn sich etwas im Mittelgebirgseinfluss ändert, dann
if there is a change,
das eigentlich kombiniert sein mit einer Änderung
it should normally be combined with a change in the wind direction, because the wind direction is decisive for the distribution of effects, shadowing effects, back pressure effects. So the question is, have there already been any changes in flow directions? And so far as we see it now, we see a change in frequencies, in occurrences of southwest streams between 1961 and 1990. and the current 1981 to 2010 period. We see an increase in frequency of southwest weather conditions, but this is a general European scale. It's not just a regional Saxon scale. The question is, will that continue to have the same shadowing effects and back pressure effects? So I use projections, extrapolations, I use the CLM model from the 2007 assessment report 1, which corresponds to our projections. Let's have a look at the wind speeds during the periods, the first decade, beginning at the end of last century and one at the beginning of the century. So we see that the wind speed in general is not expected, it's not projected to change for the grid points in Saxony, on the basis of the grid points of the CLM model. For the wind direction, we see changes. Southwest flows will reduce in occurrence, in frequency, and of course this will give different impacts. If we have less southwest directions, we will have less back pressure effects, and the shadowing effects will increase if there are more. And so that's the conclusion already. I try to stick to the time limit. What can we say? Will there be a change in Saxony as to the impact of the uplands for temperature and precipitation trends? We think that there will be similar trends in the uplands as to those in the lowlands, and if there are wind direction distributions different from today's directions, then we will have different impacts, and the projections are diverging. So in any case, we will have another differentiation, another variation in Saxony, changes in back pressure and shadowing areas, and change in intensities of those effects, and changes in regional climate in terms of precipitation, temperature, sun hours, and also in terms of foehn winds, cold winds, depend. For all those projections, we must bear in mind that there are a lot of uncertainties attached there too. Here we have quotation forecasts are difficult, especially when regarding the future. Thank you for your attention. Many thanks, Valeri. I think there should be enough impetus for questions.
Geht auch mit Mikro. Ich habe im Grunde zwei Fragen. Das eine ist die sehr hoch aufgelösten Karten zum Einfluss der verschiedenen Wetterlagen auf Sonnenschein und so weiter. Was ist die Datenquelle dafür in dieser Auflösung?
What is the database behind this resolution? Where does the grid come from? On the second hand, you had slides as to the question whether the vertical temperature gradient will change for the future. Wetrack data are used, I think. These are observed. These are recombined projections. So normally you cannot expect any change signal. So that means that the database does not provide scope. As to METREG, so I should transfer that to the people delivering, providing us with the data. As to your first question, as to the spatial resolution, it's RECIS, the RECIS data platform. These are interpolated data, well-documented interpolation processes were used based on Astra 1 kilometer grids, based on the station data and then interpolated data. So originally station data, but the grid field was interpolated from those from this data, depending on continentality, topography, and so on. Dr. Korndorfer. Mr. Goldberg, the Ore Mountains has two sides, north and south. If you have more south winds, then there will be more precipitation because of a back pressure effect. And then the water will come to us, to Dresden. So are there any forecasts for our Czech colleagues? It would be also very interesting. The point is that the south slopes and south conditions are always associated with high pressure zones. And there the soil or the ground flow is northwest. So when we have south wind, the pressure distribution is high pressure from East Europe. So we would have more föhn winds, more fog along the ridges. But I would not see a more precipitation because of this pressure condition. So I would not think that is a necessary result. Mr. Freiland, maybe an additional comment as to the Bohemian winds. Mr. Wand invented that in the 1950s, a channeled incoming wind at the starting points of the mountains. So in Dippertiswalde, in place, in the cities, in the Baratal Valley, there you did not actually felt that. So that means that the stream was below that altitude. So for practice, the problem was air hygiene, and also for military flights. In East Germany, we had a lot of airports in Bautzen, Rothenburg, and Cottbus, military airfields, and they had difficulties to fly because there was sunshine all over the country, but there were a lot of turbulence fields due to that wind. A lot of theses and other works, papers were written, so that means there were localized channels of winds. And we as experts, we said, so it's Boxdorf is the limit. The town of Boxdorf was the limit. And there you saw the big chimney and you saw where wind came from. So this was kind of the limit. So just as a comment. And many thanks again to our speaker. So I would like, we should not...